The River Leven restoration project aims to improve a 2.5 mile section of the River Leven flowing from Windygates down to Levenmouth. Last year we completed phase one of the works on the left bank of the river by Cameron Bridge. In early summer of this year, 2024, we're delighted to be starting phase two works from Kirkland Dam down to Leven. We're looking to improve and restore sections of the river that have been changed over the last couple of hundred years. The River Leven was at one time one of the most industrialised rivers in Scotland. In the 18th century, there were several hundred mills and factories with a proud population of miners and workers in manufacturing industries. The large numbers of paper mills, flax mills, coal mining industry saw the river change as sluice gates, weirs and dams were built so the river could turn the machinery within the mills. With the closing of the mills and collapse of coal mining in the 1960s, the River Leven looks a different place now. Whilst there is still industry utilising the river further upstream, disused dams and weirs are still causing problems. These redundant structures are acting like a brick wall in the river, changing natural processes. Migratory fish, such as salmon, re-entering the river to spawn as part of their natural life cycle, aren't able to freely swim up the river to upstream habitats. Only a few under certain conditions can swim upstream, the majority unable to get past the old weirs and dams. Phase two of the River Leven restoration project focuses on the historic dams at Kirkland and Burmill. These dams have been assessed and due to their size are only passable to fish under certain limited conditions. By improving fish passage, more fish, species and different sized fish will be able to swim upstream to feed and spawn. We look forward to continuing to work closely with all partners involved and the local community as we reach this significant milestone in the wider Leven project. So here we are at the River Leven with Kirkland Dam just behind us, and this is the starting point of restoration work starting this summer.
So at Kirkland, because we can't remove the structure, we've had to come up with alternative designs to help to ease fish movement upstream and downstream of the dam. The final design, because of the height of the weir, involves the creation of a nature-like rock ramp. And what we mean by that is the placement of boulders and cobbles onto the structure and downstream of the structure to mirror the type of conditions that fish would come across in a relatively steep natural channel. The rock ramp will contain pockets of shallower water and faster flowing water, and also deeper, slower flowing water, just to allow the fish to more easily move upstream and downstream across the structure. As with all construction projects, there will inevitably be an amount of time that it'll take for the site to recover following construction. But the intention is that over time, the vegetation will green up, the rock ramp itself will become a more natural feature within the surrounding river and environment. And it'll be an area that people can really come down and enjoy as they do with the weir today.
To maximise benefits in this project, WEF have worked with a wide range of partners. And this takes time, this has taken a few years in the planning. So we're absolutely delighted to be starting a major phase of works this summer.
We've done a number of assessments through the project to determine the feasibility of removing the two dams on this section of the Lower Leven. And through those assessments and through discussions with a wide range of stakeholders, we have determined that it is possible to fully remove Burnmill Dam, which will allow the much more natural flow of the river and of sediment movement through that section of the lower site. The assessments have shown that at Kirkland Dam, it's not feasible for us to remove the structure. And so the structure has to remain in place, and we have instead looked at alternative designs that will help fish to move more easily up through the structure. One of the best things about this project is that even though we are working on such a constrained site, for example, with the railway line, the housing developments surrounding the site, and some of the utilities infrastructure, we still have a real opportunity to make a big difference, not just for the river health and the wildlife that it supports, but also to the local and wider communities who use this space. And along with the wider river park and the river park routes projects, hopefully more people will be encouraged to come down and learn and explore the River Leven and everything that this site has to offer. downstream of here and between the two dams, there's already some good examples of wet woodland habitat. So the restoration designs aim to extend that habitat upstream, and by using these areas in the woods already, excavate and gilt some additional ground to create additional low-lying areas that water can pull. Wet woodland habitat and wetland habitat that would be created upstream of here is really important for a huge range of wildlife, so it's great that we have the opportunity to do this along this section of the site.
Okay, here we are at Burr Mill, which is the most downstream redundant barrier on the River Leven. And assessments have shown that this barrier can be fully removed.
The design at this site is the full removal of the structure that you see behind us. And in doing so, what we hope to create is a much more natural looking section of the river. And without the barrier in place, that's going to allow flow and sediment to move much more freely through the system, as well as making it much easier for fish to move upstream and downstream through this section of the Leven. One of the things that we've had to do when we've designed this is consider the archaeological importance of the site. Obviously, the barrier relates to a lot of the previous industrial heritage in this area. And so as part of the works, we hope to create a record of before, during and after the construction, just to preserve the history of the dam for future generations.
So here we are just standing downstream of Burr Mill Dam and the River Leven flowing down to Levenmouth. The river here becomes really constrained, and with that, we've got limited options for restoration.
That said, we do have opportunities down this section of the river to naturalise sections of the bank that are more artificial, and also add in large ridge structures at the very downstream end of the restoration site to further improve the habitat in the channel areas.
SEPA's Water Environment Fund have been working in partnership with Fife Council to develop and deliver the project, with CBEC leading on the design and supporting the construction. Scotland Rivers have benefited from more than £25 million investment from the Water Environment Fund in the last 10 years, improving the environment for people and wildlife while also increasing resilience to climate change. Restoring the River Leven's natural course and removing the redundant barriers to migrating fish are great examples of this. It will improve fish passage, river habitats and biodiversity.